This story talks about the feelings of an athlete as he pursues his dream. Read about a nerve-wracking day in Michael Stone's life as he prepares to take the ultimate test of his sports career. It is an awe-inspiring achievement that will leave you breathless. The achievement that Michael Stone has achieved is going to make not only him, not only the audience, but if we read also, it is also equally going to have the impact on the readers. Yes, nerve-wracking. In the second line, it says, read about a nerve-wracking day in Michael Stone's life. Please make a note. Nerve-wracking means making very nervous or worried. Feeling very nervous or worried is called as nerve-wracking. So that one particular day was the ultimate test of his sports career, and his achievement is definitely an inspiration for all of us, because he is the person who is visually impaired. Visually impaired means he couldn't see. He cannot see. But that did not stop him from achieving his goal. Okay? That is why the writer mentions it as a nerve-wracking day in Michael Stone's life. Yes? Now, if you could see and relate to the picture, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What are the 10 points, 10 stages that are involved in the game? Pole vault. Yes, Michael Stone is associated with the game pole vault. Okay, see, for you to better understand what is a pole vault, there is a picture that is given in the lesson. If you could see in page number 27, at the beginning of the page, you have the picture. That's a pole. They take with the help of the pole and take a jump from there. Yes. So this is the experience on his D-Day. His palms were sweating. He needed a towel to dry his grip. A glass of ice water quenched his thirst, but hardly cooled his intensity. The AstroTurf he sat on was as hot as the competition he faced today at the National Junior Olympics. The pole was set at 17 feet. That was 3 inches higher than his personal best. Michael Stone confronted the most challenging day of his pole vaulting career. The stands were still filled with about 20,000 people, even though the final race had ended an hour earlier. Yes, could you just try to visualize how many people were there? Why is it a D-Day? Why was he sweating? Okay, see, when anybody is nervous, we sweat. Some of them sweat. Some of them are into the habit of nail biting. Yes, some of them are into the habit of running their fingers. Okay, different mannerisms. Okay, so on that particular day, his palms were sweating. Whose palms? Michael Stone's. He needed a towel to dry his grip. Grip is nothing but to hold something very firmly, tightly. A glass of ice water quenched his thirst, but hardly cooled his intensity. Intensity here is the severity. The AstroTurf he sat on was as hot as the competition he faced at the National Junior Olympics. Children, what do you understand by AstroTurf? Yes, what is an AstroTurf? An AstroTurf is nothing but the artificial grass that is being put in the playground where one sits and takes rest. Okay, where one sits during a competition. Okay. The pole was set at 17 feet. Usually if we take the average height of a human being is only 6 feet. Okay, it ranges from 5 feet, 5.5 to 6. Imagine 17 feet. 17 feet is quite high.